right, on this one, a little bit, windy up here today. Thank goodness it's not cold. Boy, it will be, it would be brutal up here. But they said this one's not running. What seems to be is, I check the, it's a three phase. I check between each line here. First thing I did was try to jump it out and see if I can get it to run to eliminate the thermostat wire and the thermostat. The fan on the indoor came on. But when the compressor tried to come on, it sounded like it didn't have enough power to do what it's supposed to do. So, next thing I checked, and since both of them were doing it, so I checked the high voltage coming in. So I checked here, and the high leg, the blue one, wasn't quite giving me what I was expecting for it to give me. It was kind of low. So I turned the disconnect off, turned it back on two or three times, and said maybe it's just a bad connection in there or whatever. And I come back here, I'm getting the same thing. And then I did it again, and I got nothing on there. So I came over here, check the fuses and be sure they're not loose and all. And the fuses, when I check the fuses, if I put it on the right thing, good, all fuses are good. Now when I turn it on, between this one, I get 212. Down here, I get 212. Now when I jump between the middle, still get 212. That's what fooled me, because it's back feeding through the system. So I came here and read on the fuse and the line is coming in, and I still read 212. So reading on this fuse and reading on this terminal in the middle up here, I should not get any reading because it's on. So it's the same line. The only way that I can get voltage between here and here is because there's an open link somewhere from here to here. So I go and check the fuse. If I can do this, check this here. I'm going to put it on the top of the fuse to eliminate of it being the fuse that is a bad link. Check the top. I still get 212. Now, just to be sure it's on, I come over to this one. Hopefully you can see it. I'm going all the way to the first one on the left and do the same thing. And I get zero. Over here on the third one, I get zero. Now, when I go in here in the middle and do the same thing, I get 212. So that is telling me that the device in here in the middle is not tying this fuse to this leg up here, which is the high leg in the middle. That is why the compressor, or both compressors, are running, because it's like trying to run without a capacitor. It don't have that high leg to it. So we don't change these. We tell him to call an electrician. Anything after this, we fix. Anything before that, call somebody else. And just with all the wind, I don't know if you can hear it or not, but I'll give it a try. Let you hear what the compressor sounds like. So if you ever hear it do the same thing on you, you might have the same problem. So let's try the compressor here and see what it sounds like. That's one. Get over to the second one. Yeah, this is the second one. It's like you can't run. That's because the high leg is not there. It's got line one, line two, 240, but it don't have the high leg, so it don't have nothing to get it to go. So we're gonna close this one up. Tell them to call an electrician. We're gonna go on to the next one.